We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Doctor Doom, Issue 5. This is written by Christopher Cantwell, art by Salvador Larroca, color art by Guru-eFX, letters by VC's Cory, Petit, cover by Tomm Coker and Michael Garland. Cover's pretty cool, tells you nothing about what's going on, and his hands look gigantic. Otherwise, it's okay, I don't mind it. Graphic design by Carlos Lau, assistant editor Shannon Andrews Bellatros, associate editor Alana Smith, editor Tomm Brevoort. The first half of this story is a lot of walking around, a little boring. Doom's still having flashbacks. There's this blonde lady hanging around checking these like weather machines. They're working on weather modification, and Doom's looking up stuff at the library. He figures out who this woman is from his visions. It's that woman on the islands. He has a little argument with Kang for some reason. Blue Marvel's wandering around. Thanks to the fact that nobody understands changing Wi-Fi passwords, Silver Sable's able to find out what Blue Marvel knows. Blue Marvel's kind of figured out some stuff, and they all kind of converge on the same places, which leads to, naturally, a bunch of misunderstandings. And we're left with Doom finally getting his testosterone back and acting like Dr. Doom. There is a death in this issue that was kind of pointless, but understandable, I guess, of a very peripheral character. And Dr. Doom finally comes to terms with who dethroned him, at least in his mind, and what he thinks is going on. Overall, the story's okay. It just drags a little. Felt very stretched out. A lot of this could have been done in half an issue, but they got to pad it for the trade paperback. The whole subplot with the overthrow and dethroning of Dr. Doom was interesting, although he has little regard for the loyalty of his lackeys, which is a little surprising, so I thought that was a little stupid. But beyond that, a lot of it was just kind of slapdash together. The story with the scientist lady, she made a lot of apologies for Latveria at the beginning, and that was kind of stupid. There's a part where Victorious and Sable are at a bar because everybody's a raging drunk in the Marvel Universe, and they get hit on by an evil man, and so they have to beat up the evil white man to prove their point and how powerful they are. I don't know. I guess that's some strong independent woman crap, but overall, it was an okay story that just took too long to get to its point, and Dr. Doom finally kind of comes out of his silly little funk or whatever and seems to be getting a little bit more hardcore. So next issue probably be better. The art in this one isn't bad. I think they're really underselling Blue Marvel. He kind of comes off as a weakling in this, and that's really disappointing. This series is just kind of dragging on and it's getting a little tiresome. I'll probably drop it. I don't much care for supervillain books to begin with, but this started out with such a bang and now it's just kind of meandering. So hopefully it picks up. So I'll give it another issue or two, but beyond that, I'm probably going to drop it if it doesn't change. So I'll recommend it if you can find it for less than cover price. But that's just my take. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit like and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.